and I have decided to come and tell you guys today if it's really worth it. Is it really, really worth it to make your wedding gown by yourself or just simply buy it? Because a lot is involved. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, you're welcome. I'm sure you guys have been enjoying the wedding diary series. I've been putting up videos on how I made my wedding gown, how I cut my wedding gown, what I bought to make my wedding gown. It's just been a whole lot, and I noticed you guys have been enjoying the videos, and I've been enjoying the videos myself as well. I enjoyed filming it and editing it, even though the editing took a really, really long time. Okay guys, one question I've been getting is, how much did you spend to make your wedding gown? How much did you spend to make your wedding gown? And I have decided to come and tell you guys today if it's really worth it. Is it really, really worth it to make your wedding gown by yourself or just simply buy it? Because a lot is involved and a lot of you want to know so that you know what you're getting into. And in today's video, I'm just going to explain to you the simplest way, the easiest way, and how much I spent to make my wedding gown. I don't know why I added the simplest way and easiest way, probably because that's what I always say in all my tutorials. So you want to find out how much I spent to make my wedding gown, definitely keep watching. Before we go into the video, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so that whenever I post a video, you will get notified. Okay, I have my book here, and I also have my notepad here because of course I want to write everything down now. So if you don't know, I have a full video on the things I bought to make my wedding dress. I'll link that video down in the description box so that if you want to have like a detailed view of all the things I used to make my wedding dress, you would see that. So I'm just going to link that in the description box. Make sure you check it out. So I made my wedding gown with a satin, and for this satin, see, I made the wedding dress and I also made the one for the little bride, okay? So myself and the little bride, all the things I'm going to mention here are the things I used both for myself and the little bride, and I had a lot left, okay? Now, I bought 12 yards of satin. It's not Duchess satin, it's just like the normal white satin, but there are different textures to the fabric. And I went with my mom to the market. After we checked the texture we wanted, a lot of them I can't exactly remember the exact price because we negotiated, but I gave like a close range. In fact, I gave almost the exact prices for everything. The ones I'm not sure of, I'm going to tell you guys. So for the satin, I got 12 yards and we bought it for around 350 per yard. And I got 12 yards. Then I went ahead to buy the pongia lining, which I showed you guys in my video on the things I bought to make my wedding gown. And I bought 10 yards of that, and that went for 200 naira, okay? Then I bought the this net. In Nigeria they call it soft net, but we call it two net. So but the one I bought is this shiny one, and it's a little stronger. Those are the ones they use for the wedding veils, and I bought that one for 250 and I got 8 yards of that. Then I went ahead to buy the hard net. The hard net is what you need to make the gown stand, okay? And I got 10 yards of that at 350. Then I bought the zip. I bought a dozen, I think about half dozen or a dozen, I can't really remember, but one zip went for 200 naira. And I know a lot of people DM'd me on Facebook, and I think someone here left a comment that, oh, they cheated you, zips are not that expensive, why would you buy one zip for almost 200 naira? See guys, when it comes to zippers, whatever you call it, there are different grades, okay? In Nigeria here, there's some zippers that go for 1,500, there's some that go for 400, there's some that go for 500, there's some that go for 50 naira, there's some that go for 200 naira, okay? So the one I use is the one that one goes for 200 naira. And to you, you might feel, oh, this is too expensive, but from where I bought, that's the price. And these are zippers that you keep using till you are tired of. It's something I have attested to. I've used it. My mom has used it in a lot of my dresses, and they do the job. So I got it. I just had to put this out there because I got a lot of questions and backlash for buying an expensive zip. It's really not that deep, guys. It's not. So I bought one zip. The white one I used, I bought that one for 200. Then I bought 8 yards of organza, and 1 yard went for 200 naira. Okay, 1 yard of organza is 200 naira. Then I got 5 yards of gum stay, and 1 yard is 120. And I bought thread. If you are selling a wedding gown, you know you're not just going to buy one thread. But I didn't buy like a whole dozen of thread. I bought half dozen of thread, and one dozen of thread is around 600. So I bought half dozen, which is 300. So I'm just going to run through like the breakdown of how much it costs. So for the satin, I got the satin at 350 for 12 yards, and this summed up to 4,200. The pongier lining, see, if you guys watch my other video, you know that I have issues with calling this lining. I think my mom says it's pongier or sponger. I don't know. Pongier lining. The pongier lining I got was at the rate of 200 naira, and I got 10 yards of that lining, which amounted to 2,000 naira, okay? Then the two nets, that one I used for my wedding veil. And if you don't know, the next video coming up will be a video on how I made my wedding veil. So just watch out for that. It's going to be up soon. The two net I bought down at 250, and I got 8 yards of that. So 250 times 8 times 8, that is 2,400, okay? Then I got the hard net. The hard net was what I used to line my wedding dress to make it stand. And I got that one for, I got 10 yards of that at 350, and that is 3,500. Then I got my zipper for 200 naira, like I've earlier established and explained. Then I got the organza. I got my organza for 200 naira, and I bought 8 yards, and that amounted to 1,600. I got my gum stay, and I bought 5 yards of gum stay at 120 naira, and everything summed up to 600 naira. Then I got my thread, half dozen of thread went for 300. So if you add 4,200 plus 2,000 naira plus 2,400 plus 3,500 plus 200 plus 1,600 plus 600 naira, plus 300 naira, everything summed up to 14,800, which is cheap, right? Very, very cheap. Now, this is not inclusive of the fuel I bought, because I don't know if you guys watched that video. I said our transformer blew, so I was running the production of my wedding dress on fuel, and it consumed a lot. But for me, I just feel that for me, if you know how to make, you know how to sew very, very well, it will be cheaper for you to make your wedding dress, okay? If you know how to sew very, very, very well, it will be cheaper for you to make your wedding dress. But if your sewing skills, you can't really vouch for your sewing skills. You are not sure, okay? You are not very sure. There are certain styles you've not tackled, and you want to jump in to make your wedding dress. It might end up becoming more expensive for you. Because you might go for an, you might end up becoming more expensive for you. Let me explain. Because number one, you might end up ruining the fabric and you have to start all over again. So that would be both material, you've wasted the material, you've wasted your intellectual strength, you've wasted your energy. And if, let me say, the fabric you used was an expensive fabric and you ruined it, is either maybe you start sewing it all over again, or you go over to rent, or you go over to buy, and that way it wouldn't be way much more expensive for you, okay? So if people, when people ask me that, oh, would you rather rent or buy, so when some people tell me, oh, Ada, should I buy my wedding dress, or I should rent, or I should sew, I ask them, okay, if you want to sew your wedding dress by yourself, what are your sewing, as in how good are your sewing skills, okay? If your sewing skills are good, they are around, like, if on a range of 10, you have about 7. If it's as high as 7, then I think that's very, very good. Then you can attempt making your wedding dress. But if it's around 4, 3, I wouldn't really advise you, because that way it will be more expensive for you in the long run, because you end up wasting lots of fabric, wasting your time, wasting your effort, even wasting the time of your fiance, because trust me, he really wants you to come out gorgeous that day. So renting or buying, for me that I know how to sew to an extent, I won't tell you guys that I'm a pro, okay? But for me that I know how to sew to an extent, it is cheaper for me to sew my wedding dress than to rent or buy, okay? So I got other questions here that I want to attend to regarding to the wedding dress. So somebody asked, how much did you spend in making your wedding dress? So I've talked about, I've given you guys a total in this video. I spent 14,800 naira. That's the general fee. Let's say for fuel, I bought fuel of around 3,000 naira. So 14,800 plus 3,000 naira, that is, no, I'm not good with math, 15, 16, 17. That's 17,800. So let's say plus fuel, I spent roughly 17,800 naira to make my wedding dress. Okay. Now, somebody asks, how many yards did you use for the flare? See, I don't know how many yards I used for the flare, because the flare was cut. See, I don't know. I can't tell you that, okay, I used 1 yard, or I used 2 yards, or I used 3 yards. It was a very, very long thread, and I divided the thread into two parts. So I can't tell you this is how many yards I used. All I know is I just kept cutting and cutting, and I had lots of fabric left. I even made the dress for the little bride, and I still have fabric left at home here. Okay, maybe I'll use that to make for my daughter by the time I eventually give birth to a girl. Okay, so this is how much I spent. I don't think I got another question with regards to the wedding dress. I asked lots of questions about, I put a poll on Instagram and on Facebook, and these are just the questions. Most of the questions I got were, how much did you spend? How much did you spend? How much? This is how much I spent to make my wedding dress. And for me, it is cheap. And it is cheap for me because I know how to sew. But if you are just learning to sew, your stitches are not very straight, you're not very, very sure, I'd rather you give someone else who is a pro, you know, somebody who knows how to sew, you contract her to make your wedding dress for you, or you buy or you rent. Okay, and there are different places where you can buy or rent very close to you or online, so that you look really beautiful and really gorgeous on your wedding day. The next video that is going to be coming up is a video on how I made my wedding veil. Please, please, please watch out for that video. It's something you'd enjoy. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so that whenever I post a video, you will get notified. I want to get to 200k this year, so please, 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 and please hit the subscribe button. I'll see you in my next video, or in these videos here. Bye.